Hello everyone, welcome to Students Point. This is 14th of March and today's video is a special one because in this video I have compiled all those important government schemes which were in news in recent times. So every sentence of this video is very important, watch till end very carefully. So let's begin. First let's see the question for the day which you have to answer in the comment section, and next day, that is on Sunday, we will see how many of you were the most consistent in answering all the questions correctly throughout the week. So let's see the question. IUCN had classified giraffes as, these are the options. IUCN categorizes species of plants and animals based on their threat to extinction into 9 different categories. Out of this, giraffe is categorized into one. So read the options and then answer. And at different occasions, I have created some special videos which are very, very important for you. For instance, on 22nd February, I have completed Union Budget 2022-2021. So you should mark the date of this 22nd February video so that you may revise the budget before examinations very quickly. Similarly, this video is very important, so you should also mark the date of 14th of March so that before examinations you may revise all these government schemes which were in news recent times. So let's begin. The first question: which of the following statement or statements about Sukanya Samridhi Yojana is or are correct? Let's see. Sukanya Samridhi Yojana encourages parents to build a fund for the future education and marriage expenses for their female child. This statement is correct. And the account will be valid for 21 years from the date of opening, after which it will mature. So this statement is also correct. See, under this Sukanya Samridhi Yojana, there is a provision for opening an account, and this account will be valid for 21 years from the date of opening of that account, after which that account will be mature. And after the maturity of that fund, the money will be given to the girl on whose name the account was opened. So here C is the right answer. And Sukanya Samridhi account has a provision of minimum deposit of ₹250. Earlier it was ₹1000, but now it has been reduced to ₹250 and maximum deposit of ₹1.5 lakh per year. Focus here that per year only ₹1.5 lakh can be deposited in this account and a minimum of ₹250 can be deposited. And parents or legal guardians can open only one account in the name of one girl child. Earlier there was provision that only two accounts can be opened in the name of two different girl childs, which meant that if parents have three or four girl child, accounts will be opened only for two, not for third and fourth girl child. But this provision has been changed by government recently, and now parent can open account for more than two girl child as well. But there is condition: if accounts are to be opened in case of more than two girl child, then along with the birth certificate, an individual is required to submit an affidavit. And as per the new rules, the account will be operated by guardian till the account holder, that is the girl child, attains the age of 18 years. After attainment of 18 years, girl will be the holder of this account, and after maturity of 21 years, the whole money of this account will be given to that girl. Next question: consider the following statements regarding Prime Minister Kusum. Let's see the options. Ministry of New and Renewable Energy has launched this scheme. This scheme stands for Pradhan Mantri Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uthan Mahabhiyan. This statement is correct. Remember, the ministry of any government schemes is very important. So MNRE has launched this PM Kusum, and the scheme empowers farmers to be producer of energy. Not buyer of energy, rather producer of energy. So here both these statements are correct. C is the right answer. And it covers grid connected renewable energy power plants, stand alone solar powered agriculture pumps, and solarization of existing grid connected agriculture pumps. So all these three components are part of this scheme. I repeat it once again: grid connected renewable energy plants means those plants which are connected to any grid are part of it, otherwise those solar powered agriculture pumps, which are standalone, which are not connected to any grids, but only they are in different agriculture field of farmers. They are also part of it, and government also aims to solarize all the existing grid connected agriculture pumps. Next question. Consider the following statements about one stop center scheme. One stop centers are being established across the country to provide integrated support and assistance under one roof to women affected by violence, both in private as well as in public sphere. This statement is correct. So focus here that one stop center scheme not only focuses on public spaces but also on private spaces. Next statement, the scheme is funded through Nirbhaya Fund. We have several times discussed about Nirbhaya Fund, and this scheme is funded through Nirbhaya Fund. So here both these statements are correct. C is the right answer. And the scheme started on 1st of April 2015. The scheme is also called as Sakhi. And Ministry of Women and Child Development has formulated this one stop center. And it is a sub scheme of umbrella scheme for National Mission for Empowerment of Women, including Indira Gandhi Matritva Sahyog Yojana. And it is a centrally sponsored scheme. Remember it? It is not a central sector scheme, rather it is a centrally sponsored scheme. Next question. Consider the following statements about Ayushman Bharat. The Ayushman Bharat National Health Protection Scheme provide health insurance of rupees 5 lakh per family per year. This statement is correct. So focus here, rupees 5 lakh per family per year, and it is an entitlement based scheme. And it targets beneficiaries as identified by latest socio-economic caste census data. So this statement is also correct. So here C is the right answer. And this scheme covers 10 crore families. And center and state share ratio is of 60:40. That is 60% of the total cost is borne by central government and 40% of the total cost is borne by state government. And Ayushman Bharat adopts two pronged approach. The first one is creation of health and wellness centers to bring healthcare to closer to homes. So it will create centers at different places, and it also aims to formulate Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana to protect poor and vulnerable families against financial risk arising out of catastrophic health episodes. Next question. Umeed initiative is launched for genetic disorder. Yes, C is the right answer. And this initiative is designed on the concept of prevention is better than cure. And this Umeed, which stands for unique methods of management and treatment of inherited disorders, is supported by Department of Biotechnology. Remember this department? Department of Biotechnology supports this initiative, and it has three components. What are those? It aims to establish Nidan Kendras, which are called as diagnostic center. It also aims to produce skilled clinicians in human genetics, and then a screening of pregnant women and newborn babies in hospital in aspirational districts. Next question. Kali Tiger Reserve is located in Karnataka. This was the previous day question. Next, consider the following statements regarding Shyama Prasad Mukherjee Rural Urban Mission. See here, R Urban is read as Rural Urban Mission. So it was launched by Ministry of Rural Development in 2016. This statement is correct. Remember this year and this ministry. Ministry of Rural Development launched this scheme in year of 2016, and it aims to deliver integrated project-based infrastructure in the rural areas. This statement is also correct. So here again C is the right answer. Under this scheme, government aims to provide urban facilities in the rural areas itself. So here C is the right answer. And provisions of urban amenities to rural areas, that is Pura, announced in 2003, was predecessor of SPRM. So earlier there was a scheme which was called as provisions of urban amenities to rural areas, but it was later succeeded by this Shyama Prasad Rural Urban Mission. And why it was in news? Because 4th anniversary was celebrated of the scheme on 21st of February 2020. Next question. Consider the following statements related to Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samman Nidhi, that is PM Kisan in short. It is a central sector scheme. Focus here that PM Kisan is a central sector scheme with 100% funding from Government of India. This statement is correct. And it provides an income support of rupees 6,000 per year to all farmer families. What are those families? A family under this scheme includes parents and their minor children. See, if a parent have children above the age of 18 years, they will not be included in this definition of family. Only minor child and parent will be included in this definition of families under this scheme. So let's see, farmer families across the country in three equal installments of rupees 2000. So rupees 6000 will not be given once, it will given in three different installments of rupees 2000 each every 4 months. So here again both these statements are correct. C is the right answer. And definition of family, as I told, includes husband, wife, minor children, and the scheme is effective from 1st of December 2018. The date is also important. It was actually a backdated scheme. So the scheme was effective from 1st of December 2018 itself. And the responsibility of identification of beneficiary farmers of this scheme solely rests on state government or the union territory government. And there are also some exclusion list, means those who are not eligible under this scheme. They include all those who hold constitutional posts like president, governor and other posts, all those who are engineers, lawyers, doctors and others, and those who are or were ministers, MPs or MLAs or other constitutional dignitaries. So these all are not included as a beneficiary under this scheme. Next question. Consider the following statements regarding National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. It aims to enhance agriculture productivity, especially in rain-fed areas. This statement is correct. It is based on use of land use survey, soil profile study and soil analysis. So here both these statements are correct. C is the right answer. And it aims to promote location-specific integrated or composite farming systems, and it is one of the 8 missions outlined under National Action Plan on Climate Change. And it aims at promoting crop diversification, adoption of crop livestock farming systems and integrated approaches like crop sericulture, agroforestry and fishing farmers. So if you find the video useful, don't forget to like it, subscribe to the channel and answer the question in the comment section, and wait for the next video. Till then, stay safe.